Hi, I'm Rob Collum with SAS, and today we're here to talk about understanding network configuration variables in SAS Viya 3.5. Let's start with some general concepts about networking and what that means for SAS software. Here, we've got a single server machine for SAS Viya software. The topics discussed today apply to single machines, but they're more interesting when Viya is deployed on multiple hosts, and even more so when the SAS Cloud Analytics Services, or what we call CAS, software is deployed on multiple hosts as well. And remember that CAS hosts take on different roles, such as controllers and workers, to do their job. Hook them all up on the network so they can talk to each other, and don't forget that Viya users will need access over the network to the Viya software services as well. Now imagine you're on your PC and you want to communicate with one of the Viya hosts. Use the NSLookup utility to get network information about our server via one.site.com. From the results, we can see that your PC reached out to the DNS server, and the DNS server searched for via one.site.com in its lookup table and returned the IP address it found, and that's shown on your PC in the result. Basically, this DNS lookup process occurs for each new connection to any machine on the network when referenced by name. If you log on to the Viya 1 host yourself and query it for IP address and its fully qualified domain name, or FQDN, then you should see the same values. As a general convention, the FQDN returned from the hostname utility is typically considered the default hostname for a machine, and we confirm that here. Let's look inside this Viya 1 host and see what networking equipment it has. There's one network interface card, or NIC, and it's associated with an IP address. That IP address is associated with the Viya 1.site.com name. Oh, but look, there's a second NIC in this host, and it's associated with a different IP address, which has its own name too. And a third one as well. When there's more than one NIC in a host, we refer to that condition as multi-NIC or multi-homed. But wait, there's DNS too, and in this list we see the names and IP addresses referred to inside the Viya 1 host, but there are also additional names that resolve to those IP addresses, and those are DNS aliases, which are additional names that can be referenced on the network to access this machine. So now ask yourself, how does Viya know which hostname, IP address, NIC, or DNS alias to use for its network communications between servers and clients? Before we answer that, let's see a couple of example topologies. Returning to our network diagram, let's add a second network. This illustrates the Viya host with at least two NICs and two IP addresses. The gray dotted line at the bottom is intended for IT administrative use only. It's running on relatively slow infrastructure. This means the original blue network at the top, which connects the Viya servers with the end users, will be the primary network used for all Viya traffic. Now, this is a valid network topology that we've seen at customer sites, but it's not very interesting for our discussion today. While we need to configure Viya to work properly with two networks like this, we're pretty much just ignoring the admin network. So let's consider another network. This time it'll be very high throughput network that provides the Viya services with a dedicated back channel for best performance. Notice that we want the high performance network to act as the primary network for Viya traffic. Now, end users don't have access to the high performance network, but they do still need access to Viya services, and we'll refer to theirs as the external network. This is also where understanding the CAS server roles is important. The CAS workers do not usually present any client-facing connection points, so you should either not connect them to the external network or employ firewall rules to protect them. To handle all of these network complexities, SAS Viya 3.5 provides several network configuration parameters. The first two are used by Viya to identify the host. This is useful when it advertises the Viya services, registers them in the SAS configuration server for discovery, and so on. The next set of bind variables direct the Viya software as to which network interface to use for communicating. And the last two variables are useful to provide subject alternative names to be added to the TLS encryption certificates when Viya services might be reached using names or IP addresses that are unknown to Viya. There's also another entire set of these variables for Viya services which are contacted from external sources, like clients. So the primary set of variables tell Viya how to communicate on the network, and the client-facing external variables are optional to specify if they're needed. Of the primary variables, two in particular drive the whole shebang. SAS hostname and SAS bind adder are key to how Viya determines its network connectivity. So we briefly mentioned the idea of an external network and client-facing services, but I bet you're wondering which Viya services we're talking about. As it turns out, not many. For example, much of the Viya infrastructure is tucked neatly behind a single point of contact, the Apache HTTP server, and that acts as a reverse proxy. This means that a multitude of Viya services and web applications can all be accessed through a single route. CAS itself also offers its own client-facing APIs for direct programming access. Depending on your selection of Viya software, there may be other services to consider as well. This separation of client traffic from heavy-duty back-end communication gives Viya flexibility to optimize for its topology and gives IT administrators the confidence of clear traffic protection. So let's look closer at those two key network configuration variables. The value of SAS hostname is what SAS Viya services should use to reference this machine for network communication and for services registration in the SAS configuration server. It's also used as the common name for TLS certificates that are generated for this machine. The value of SAS bind adder is used for identifying the network interface Viya should expect to communicate on. The other network configuration variables are supplementary to these two in different ways, and I'll show what I mean by this shortly. The first two supplementary variables to consider are the external equivalents for hostname and bind adder. SAS external hostname has the same job as the primary SAS hostname variable, but is specific only to the client-facing public Viya interfaces. Notice that if you don't specify a value for external hostname, then it defaults to the value of SAS hostname. The same concept holds for the external bind adder in that it should specify the network interface for public Viya services to listen on, but if it's not specified, it defaults to the value of the primary variable, SAS bind adder. Remember, the external variables only apply to network communication for a small set of Viya services which present public interfaces. There are also some bind variables which are supplementary too. SAS bind adder if allows you to specify a network interface by its name. If this variable is used, then the SAS bind adder variable will be set to the first IP address found for that specified network interface. SAS bind adder cider can be used to specify a range of possible IP addresses. If this variable is used, then the SAS bind adder will be set to the first IP address found available in that range. And there are external equivalents for these two, which work similarly. These variables are useful in virtualized environments or wherever the Viya hosts are dynamically assigned IP address at startup. So let's step through exactly how Viya resolves these variables to understand their relationships with each other. For Viya to determine the value of SAS hostname, it looks to see if the variable has been set. If so, it uses that value. But if not, then SAS hostname will automatically be set to the equivalent of asking the operating system for this machine's fully qualified domain name. We see similar resolution rules for external hostname, but with one difference. If that variable isn't set, then it defaults to the value of SAS hostname. Now let's try something a little more complicated and look at how Viya resolves SAS bind adder. First of all, if a value for SAS bind adder has been provided, then use that. But if not, then check if SAS bind adder if has been set instead. And if it has, then SAS bind adder will be set to the first IP address found for the network interface specified. Else the next check will be SAS bind adder cider. If it's set, then SAS bind adder will be set to the first IP address found in that range. And finally, if none of those variables have been set, then SAS bind adder will default to the value 0000, which means that Viya services should listen on all network interfaces of the host for traffic. Do not set all of these values for a Viya host, just provide one. If multiple are given, Viya will only implement the most specific, as shown here. The same decision process occurs for external bind adder, but note that if none of these are set, then the default is for external bind adder to take on the same value as SAS bind adder. So with all of these diverse scenarios and complex rule interactions, let's see what happens for different use cases. First of all, let's start simple. We have a Viya host with just one NIC, and we haven't specified any of the network configuration variables at all. Effectively, this means that SAS hostname will default to the host's fully qualified domain name as queried from the OS, and SAS bind adder will default to 0000. And in this next example, we can specify an explicit IP address for Viya services on this host to use. This effectively makes Viya reliant to a permanent static IP address. Next up is a configuration which allows for dynamic IP address assignment on the primary network interface by using the SAS bind adder if parameter. We could accomplish a similar goal using SAS bind adder cider if we preferred to specify a range of candidate IP addresses instead. And then for something a little more complicated, consider a VIA deployment where communication is allowed from two different network interfaces, one with a primary network dedicated for the server backend and another for external client-facing network traffic. This last one is similar to achieve the goals of the network illustrations I showed earlier. Okay, so when exactly do we need to specify these network configuration variables? The answer is, it depends, of course. For VIA hosts with a single NIC, these variables aren't typically needed. However, for VIA hosts with multiple NICs, on the other hand, you must specify at least SAS hostname and SAS bind adder. And of course, the other variables might come in handy too. The reason why is because the SAS configuration server drives some of this technical requirement. On hosts with more than one NIC, it requires configuration to bind to a single interface. There are other network infrastructure and configuration drivers too. Now, are you excited to try this out for yourself? Let's look at where we make these configuration changes. You can and should provide these configurations when you're deploying the VIA software. To do that, you should be familiar with our Ansible-based deployment process. And if you need to specify network configuration for one or more VIA hosts of your deployment, then we rely on Ansible's paradigm for host-specific variables. The idea is to create a new YAML file named to match each host alias of the target as identified in the inventory.ini file of your SAS VIA playbook, and then place that file in a subdirectory named host_vars that you will create in the SAS VIA playbook directory on your Ansible controller. As you can see, the variables are defined using YAML syntax. Take care to include the three dashes at the top of the file and to ensure white spacing is preserved too. These host var files are processed when Ansible runs the site.yaml playbook to deploy the VIA software or to reconfigure it later. The SAS VIA deployment process creates another file with the network configurations on the targeted VIA hosts, referred to as network.conf. The intent is the exact same as the host vars YAML file to create environment variables for network configuration with the value specified, this time in shell syntax. Now, this is the live file. It is processed each time VIA services start up on the host. So, I'd like to share some proven practices with you to help guide your experience with network configuration in VIA 3.5. First off, please note that if you're using SAS Studio Basic software, then there is a pre-installation configuration that you do need to make. The SAS VIA 3.5 for Linux deployment guide explains that you must define the webdms.workspaceserver.hostname property in the SAS VIA playbook's vars.yaml file to match the effective value of SAS bind adder. Again, this only applies to sites using SAS Studio Basic components like the SAS Object Spawner and SAS Workspace Server, and not the SAS Studio Enterprise software, which relies on different VIA services for that functionality. Continuing this guidance, we recommend that you shouldn't change the values in the network.conf files directly unless it's for limited testing of a proposed change. To help keep your VIA configuration in sync for Ansible, make changes to the proper host_vars file in the SAS VIA playbook directory, and then rerun the site.yaml playbook to push the configuration changes. Note that this approach does require a scheduled outage of all VIA services. Also, these network configuration variables are not used when performing an upgrade in place from VIA 3.4. They are only for new installations of SAS VIA 3.5. Make sure your network and hosts are properly configured so that the FQDN resolves properly to the correct IP address in all directions. This is appropriate not just for VIA, but all well-designed networks. And use the SAN network configuration variables when clients might contact VIA using different host names or IP addresses than VIA is aware of. Now, if you do specify values for these variables, take care to include all possible values, not just the additional ones. We also recommend that you should not explicitly set the SAS bind adder variable equal to 0000, even though that is its default value. Instead, we recommend simply removing the variable definition. However, and this is a pro tip from me to you, you can set the external bind adder equal to 0000 if you have VIA clients which communicate with your VIA services from different networks. This ensures that the public-facing client interfaces listen for communication on all network interfaces for that host, not just one. Thank you for joining me through this tour of network configuration variables for SAS Viya 3.5. Be sure to look at the recommended resources listed below this video for more information about this topic. And we hope you enjoy using SAS Viya.